Street Stars TV.
Ah! Sorry, can I spray? Oh, my God, it's fire! I'm like, I can't spray! She's here!
No way!
She's here!
Yeah. Yes, sir. What it is? What it is? This right here is automatic, man. Understand that. See what you know about.
But you are locked in. This is Pulse 88 Radio. You are here with your girl Latoya Lavelle and Carmen London, and we are going to call Maya right now and get her to say hello. Ah, now I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yay! Everyone, this is Maya. Maya, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hello, everyone out there. It's Miss Maya, aka the Ghetto Superstar.
The Ghetto Superstar. I like that. I like that. I like that. So, Maya, what has been going on in your life recently? I've been following you. Everyone's been following you recently. We've seen some new singles out. We've seen a new EP. What brought about the return back to music?
Oh, okay. Well, I just released my 12th studio project. It's called Smooth Jones. It's my 8th independent project on my label Planet Nine. It's available everywhere worldwide digitally. And on my website exclusively, physically, on mayamaya.com. And currently on a tour until June 26th, and that will conclude the United States part one. And then international starts in August.
Yay! So you're coming to England?
I hope so.
I hope so too. That would be amazing. So we have got some questions for you, obviously, Maya. We've had some listeners send some questions in as well. I wanted to kick off with one of the questions from the listeners. One of the listeners asked, when or are you going to be bringing out a video to Team You?
Oh, so they've already chosen for me.
Yeah. There you go. They're like, where's Team You?
I can't answer that question. I have to take a vote on which video everyone wants. You know, it's been a little difficult trying to pull teeth from the fans because everyone wants something different. So I'm probably going to be shooting something at the top of June.
Okay. We're going to do Back in the Day, Maya, just quickly, if that's all right with you. One of the things, obviously, when you Google Maya, that comes up is it says that actually at a young age, you kind of lost your interest in music a little bit.
My parents had me in all kinds of classes, from gymnastics, ballet, tap, jazz, violin, piano lessons, majorettes. I got tired of doing all of the after school
activities
because I didn't have time to be a kid. So it wasn't music that I ever lost an interest in. If anything, that's one of the things that I actually did privately that my parents knew nothing about. I was doing talent shows without their knowledge. I was singing the national anthem, all kinds of stuff without them knowing because I didn't want them to turn it into a job or some type of pressure. Plus, my dad was the singer in the family. So music has always been my first love and passion. It was just all of the classes in dance that I got really tired of in when I was 10.
Okay, is there any advice that you would maybe give to some of the parents out there that might have kids that are doing the same kind of things and maybe are losing interest or anything like that? Anything that might keep them interested, speaking from personal experience, or just let them progress naturally?
Well, I think it's very important for parents to engage their children in many different activities and maybe switch up if the child is not showing interest immediately or even after a couple of years. It's really important to keep them busy, keep them engaged, and keep them socially active. But if the child, after some time, hates it, then switch up, you know. I definitely encourage you to listen to your children as well, but not allow them to be too dormant because that can lead to boredom, which can lead to trouble, you know.
Yeah.
But definitely listen to them. And it doesn't always work out when the parents say, I said so.
Yeah.
You know?
Let them be them.
Maya, it's lovely meeting you. This is Carmen London.
Hey there. Nice to meet you too.
Nice to meet you as well. I've got so many questions, but obviously limited time. What I want to know actually is, what is your favourite song you've ever made?
Ever made. Mm-hmm. Favorite song ever made. Well, I have a very, deep connection, childhood connection with this one song. It's something that my parents used to play in my early childhood. And it's called Ribbon in the Sky by Stevie Wonder.
I love that song.
About I was about 3 years old, always looking for an actual ribbon in the sky. And my father used to sing it all of the time, and he was my earliest influence in music, with musicians over the house and him always humming a song or singing it. So I would say that would be my favorite of all time, because that was my passage into music.
Okay, cool. So what about any songs that you've actually written yourself, like songs that you've sung? What is your favorite song from you, from mine?
From me?
Yeah, from you, yes. It's all about you right now, man, seriously.
Okay, my favorite song of mine, well, I would have to say this song called Nothing At All from the Liberation album. It was never a single.
Okay.
But it's one of those inspirational songs about accepting any mistakes, failures, issues, trials and tribulations, and embracing it to accept where you are now, which is alive and breathing with no regrets. So embracing all of the pains and proceeding on to a stronger you.
Can I, sorry Maya, just because you just said that, I just wanted to ask you a quick question. Obviously you've been a role model for quite a lot of females, and I saw when you was younger as well, again, you did the Secret and Self-Esteem program for young girls, and it says that you've done a lot of like body image work with girls and things like that. So is being like a feminist role model, is that something that you're interested in, or is it just you want to encourage people to do things, or like, well, not, like you just said, obviously be proud of yourselves and do what you want to do?
Well, I realized early in my childhood, from bullying, teasing, that you can go through so many issues internally without understanding how to articulate them to adults, or feeling that you're good enough, whether that's because of what you see, whether it's on television, movies, films, video games, magazines. Now we have the internet. So it's a very sensitive time for women and men, but more importantly, children that are being influenced. And I know how I was deeply affected, and I didn't even have cable when I was coming up.
Yeah.
So it's really important. Yeah, it's really important for me to make sure that I provide reality as well as fantasy, and what those two, well, what the borderline is, and understanding the breakdown of how society is set up, but also how you can nurse yourself back to health and begin accepting yourself for who you are, and really voice to young children, adolescents, adults that sort of focus on acceptance in a time of change, that things are going to change and standards will always be defined differently by so many people. So to try to fit into anything outside of who you are is very harmful, you know. Mm-hmm. And you experience it, I experience it in the entertainment business times a thousand. But coming up into a world with so many things fed at you, it's really comforting when I had a role model to pull me to the side to focus on skill sets versus exterior, you know, because that can be very damaging, and you're always changing and you're growing physically, yeah, and mentally, emotionally, all of those things as a young kid. So that's just something that is a part of me, because it is near and dear to my heart, and I definitely experienced bullying. And yeah, questioned myself early on.
Did you have any problems with the fact that your mum was obviously Italian, your dad was black, right?
Yeah.
When you was growing up, did you have any problems with race or anything like that ever? Or that wasn't something, it was just the looks thing?
Well, you know, I had emotional issues in my ballet class based on my body shape.
Okay.
My teacher would always yell at me. I had a bump, you know, I had a bump on my bum.
Okay.
And I couldn't tuck my butt in enough in ballet, which is one of the requirements. But my physique didn't allow me to fit in with the rest of the girls that were not built like me. I had bigger thighs. My physical makeup just didn't allow me to feel comfortable. And my teacher would always yell at me, even if I tried my hardest. Ballet was something that was very discouraging because of physique and what your body has to be able to do. And mine just wouldn't allow me. Regarding the neighborhood and school, of course, you know, there was a movie that came out called Jungle Fever, yeah, which talked about, you know, interracial relationships. And I got teased a lot. I got called all kinds of names, which is funny now, but you can feel like an outcast when you're growing up and feel like something is always wrong with you. If my parents were in public, we would get all kinds of weird stares, sometimes nasty stares. Mm. And, you know, the kids would be pretty awful in what they would say to me. But everyone gets teased for something, you know, when you're a kid. You just have to learn how not to internalize it and take it personal.
Mm. Wow. Maya, I noticed on your Instagram page that you're a vegan. I'm actually a vegan myself as well. I want to know, what made you change your diet? What made you, or have you always been a vegan?
I have not always been a vegan, but every year I put myself up to a 365-day challenge just for willpower to see how strong I am and what torture I can get through. So I've done pescatarianism, then vegetarianism, and then cleanses every 3 months, celibacy, alcohol, no alcohol, running a marathon. And then I said, all right, what haven't I done? So vegan was the next thing for 365 days that I chose to do. And that was actually getting out of a relationship. Before I got into this awful relationship, I was vegetarian and I stopped being a vegetarian. So after I had to end the relationship, I said, well, I need to get me back and I need to go harder and stronger. So that's how I fell into it. And I've loved it because I feel better, I look better. I'm learning all kinds of things about the environment, economics, finances, and global warming, and how it's affecting everything and everyone. So it's led me to a completely different outlook and a new set of eyes.
Wow, that's very inspirational. Seriously, it is.
Okay, well, I'm going to go. Before we get lynched here by our listeners, Maya, shout out Kieran Fearon, who said, oh my God, tell Maya I said hi, please. I still listen to her music. Fallen is my favourite.
True.
Yeah, I've been having non-stop calls all day. I just wanted to move on to your current album that you've got out, Smooth Jones. That is now out and being on my playlist and listened to repeatedly. I wanted to ask a quick question. When you're in the studio, what inspires you? Like, are these all life experiences that come through on your album, or because you're very involved in that? I've seen that you obviously get involved in the mixing, the mastering, everything. How does it work?
You know, art comes from many different places. It can be a reflection of your personal life, of your wishful thinking, something that's not quite a reality, but fantasy instead, or desires and wishes for the world, or pulling from a documentary or a movie or even a friend that you were inspired by, watching people, talking to people, communicating with people. So it comes from many different types of places. It's not always personal, but a lot of it is. And as far as the process goes, I really love production and seeing something through from beginning to end and enjoying the final product, but it is very tedious, it's very meticulous, and quite a lengthy process. But I enjoy it, and I enjoy it more when it's right. So I do have my hands in every aspect because I have to.
Enjoy it when you release new music.
It's really cool and fun. So.
Maya, I noticed that you're using Eric Bellinger's new video for Focused on You. I was just wondering, you know, are you guys good friends? Is there a relationship? Like, what's going on? Talk to me.
Okay. Eric Bellinger, he is an artist as well as a songwriter and producer. And on one of my most recent EPs called Sweet 16, we did a collaboration together on the songwriting tip as well as the featured artist tip. So he's on my Sweet 16 project called Same Page. That's the song that he's on. Mm-hmm. So in return, he asked me on a video, and I was in Australia at the time, and he said, oh, we're shooting Tuesday. I said, Oh my goodness, we're leaving Monday and we land on Tuesday morning. So maybe it's a possibility. And it just so happened that I had a flight that landed around 8 a.m. and his video set time was like 7. So it worked out perfectly. And I said, well, it's meant to be and I can do this. So let's go ahead and do it. And we knocked that out. So we've had a working relationship over the last 2 years.
Cool. That's really good.
Well, you was hot in the video, just to let you know.
You're hot on your album cover as well, I must say that. Right, Maya, I'm just going to play you a little song that someone sent in to us. They were singing your song, not one of your current ones. Apologies for the bad singing, but I promised the listener that I would play it to you. Hold on.
Even though I want to, when you put that thing on me,
Yes, I was very amused when I got that. Do you get a lot of crazy things
Was that actually singing?
It was more... Do you get a lot of crazy fans sending you things like that?
I wouldn't call them crazy.
She's laughing.
Call them enthusiastic. They're awesome.
Okay, but I like that. Enthusiastic fans. I'm a bit crazy.
Types of messages and requests and videos. It's awesome.
Ooh, what's the craziest request you've got so far? Has someone offered to buy you an elephant or anything like that?
Has someone offered to buy me what?
An elephant or anything like that. What's the craziest thing someone's offered you?
Oh my, I mean, they've offered...
He's like, I can't say that on radio. They've offered...
having a baby, they've offered to carry a child for me.
Really?
A man has offered to get pregnant for me.
What? I don't know how that's gonna kind of work, but okay.
Yeah, that's quite awesome.
Yeah, each
I
to their own.
Biologically available.
Okay. So Maya, a quick question from one other listener that I had earlier today. His name was Marky. He wanted to know whether you were single or not.
Ooh. I am single.
Oh, nice. Yeah. The guys are gonna love that.
Maya, your song Team You, absolutely love that tune. It's one of my favorite songs right now. Is Future on the vocals for that? Because someone sounds like Future. Is it Future? Is it not Future?
On the song right now or Fire?
The one, the song Team You.
Oh, Team You.
Yeah, Team You.
Okay. No, Future's not on that. That's actually one of the songwriters from the Hit List camp that sang with me. Mm-hmm. His name is DJ.
I was about to ask, what was his name?
A lot of people think it sounds like Future. Is it Future? Is it not Future? So I'm just trying to clear that up for people who are wondering as well whether it's Future or not.
Nope, it's not. It's DJ.
It's not.
How can we... What did you just say DJ's part of your hit camp?
Well, I work with a songwriting camp called The Hit List, and it consists of DJ and Zamar, and we wrote that song together. So DJ got on the mic and hyped some of the background tracks up. So that's, I guess,
that's who you can hear.
Future a little bit.
All right, Maya. Well, I know we obviously can't keep you for too much longer because we know you're very busy, and we are very, very grateful, however, for your time with us today. Just wanted to let the listeners know how they can follow you. If you could tell them your social networks, please.
Well, thank you so much. I enjoyed this interview. You can follow me on Twitter at Miss Maya. That's MissMya, and Instagram at KissMya, KissMya. My website is MayaMaya.com.
MayaMaya.com. So that's it, people. You heard it from Maya, and you heard it from Pulse.
Definitely. So keep follow her, guys. Follow her. Literally, I'm gonna follow her. I'm following her already anyway.
Yeah, I'm already following her too. I'll follow her. If you're not following her, we don't know what you're doing. We do not know. So, right, guys, I'm going to return you to Miss Carmen London so she can resume the rest of her show.
Definitely. I'm going to mix, guys, with some brand new songs from Maya's album, which is called
Smooth Jones.
Definitely. If you guys don't have it, you need to go and buy it, definitely, man, because they're all bangers.
They're all bangers. Maya, would you like to say bye again?
Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in. I will see you later on Instagram, on Twitter, and I love you so much.